Hello all, my name is Sujan George and we will be solving some examples on local attraction. The following bearings were observed where local attraction was suspected. Calculate the corrected bearings of the lines. Now, in my previous video, I had shown you the bearings in which the whole circle bearings were given. But in this case, you will find the reduced bearings are provided over here. Reduced bearings are the quadrantal bearings. Okay, as the south, west, north, east, they are indicated. So they show that the reduced bearing or quadrantal bearing are indicated over here. So the lines are given and the forebearing and back bearing of all lines are also provided. So how to solve this using the local attraction examples? Now, as in the whole circle bearing case, the forebearing and back bearing, if they differed by 180 degree, means that station was free from local attraction. But in case of reduced bearing, you have to see that the line, the forebearing and back bearing of the lines should be numerically equal only. Okay, in case of reduced bearing, the forebearing and back bearing of line should be numerically equal. But their quadrants should be opposite. In reduced bearing, the forebearing and back bearing of a line should be numerically equal and their quadrants should be opposite for that line to be free from local attraction. Okay, this is very important. This is the difference between whole circle bearing and reduced bearing. Okay, so here you have to see, you have to find the difference. Okay, now when you observe this table, you will find that line DA, the angles, they are numerically equal. See, the forebearing and back bearing of line should be numerically equal. Means in line DA, the forebearing and back bearing values are numerically equal and their quadrants should be opposite. Here it is south, so here it is north. Here it is east, here it is west. Means their quadrants are opposite. Hence, we can say that this DA, points D and E, are free from local attraction. As forebearing and back bearing of line DA are numerically equal and their quadrants are opposite, hence stations D and A are free from local attraction. Clear? So stations D and A are free from local attraction. Now, if we need to plot the corrected bearings for these, so what we'll have to do? We'll have to go to this line DA. So as it is, as lines and as stations D and A are free from local attraction, forebearing of DA and back bearing of DA will be correct only. Hence, fore bearing of DA and back bearing of DA will be correct. Will be correct. So this value will be correct. These values will be correct. Also, the fore bearing of AB should also be correct because AB is measured from this point A. Okay. AB is measured from point A. Hence, so fore bearing of AB will also be correct. That is south 40 degree 30 minute west. Now, then what will be the actual back bearing of AB? Actual back bearing of AB will be this value. Here the value is given as 41 degree 15 minutes. So actual back bearing of AB will be what? This value should be equal only 40 degree 30 minutes, but the quadrant should be opposite. Means it should be, if it is south, it should be north, and if this is west, this should be east. And numerical, this number will be same as it is. So it will be north 40 degree 30 minute east, the actual back bearing of AB. That is north 40 degree 30 minute east. But what is the observed back bearing of AB? The observed back bearing of AB is given as north 41 degree 15 minute east. North 41 degree 15 minute east. Therefore, correction will be what? Correction will be actual minus observed. Correction will be actual minus observed. So actual value is this, observed value is this, that is 40 degree 30 minute minus 41 degree 15 minute. So this value, it comes out to minus 0 degree 45 minute, and this should be applied at point B. This value should be applied at point B. Next, the correct forebearing of BC will be what then? See, this is BC. So, forebearing of BC observed is this value. But to this value, you will have to add this correction. Okay, means to south 80 degree 45 minute west, you will have to add this value, that is minus 0 degree 45 minutes. So what you will get? You will get the value as south 80 degree 0 minute west. The value comes out to south 80 degree 0 minute west. So actual back bearing of BC will be what then? Now this is south 80 degree west. So this will be north 80 degree 0 minute east. It should be numerically equal, but opposite quadrants. If it is south, it should be north. If it is west, it should be east. But what is the observed back bearing of BC? Observed back bearing of BC is given as north 79 degree 30 minute east. North 79 degree 30 minute east. Therefore, correction that has to be applied is actual minus observed. That is actual minus observed. It is 80 degree minus 79 degree 30 minute. So this comes out to plus 0 degree 30 minute at point C. Means at point C, you will have to apply 0 degree 30 minute correction. Next, what will be the correct forebearing of CD? Now, to observed four bearing of sea days north 19 degree 30 minute east. To this north 19 degree 30 minute, this correction has to be applied. Okay, so north 19 degree 30 minute east plus that correction, that is 0 degree 30 minute. So how much it comes out to? It comes out to north 20 degree 0 minute east. North 20 degree 0 minute east. So the actual back bearing of CD should be what then? It will be 20 degree 0 minute itself, but here it will be south and here it will be west. Okay, opposite, it will be, quadrants will be opposite, but values will be same only. This number will be same only. But this south 20 degree 0 minute west is equal to the observed value of CD itself. See, this is the observed value of CD. This is equal to the observed value of CD itself, which is equal to observed value of back bearing of CD. Why this value is correct? Because this CD is measured, back bearing of CD is measured from the point D itself. When the prismatic compass is placed at D, we can measure the back bearing of CD because D is free from local attraction. D is free from local attraction. Hence, this value will also be correct. So we have checked it. Therefore, this is checked. This is checked and found correct. Okay. So this is how you will be solving the problems on local attraction if the reduced bearings are provided to you. If the whole circle bearing is provided, the method is different. But when reduced bearing is provided, this method you have to actually apply. Okay?